Welcome to the Data Science Ethics Podcast. My name is Lexi and I'm your host. This podcast is free and independent thanks to member contributions. You can help by signing up to support us at datascienceethics.com. For just $5 per month, you'll get access to the members-only podcast, Data Science Ethics in Pop Culture. At the $10 per month level, you will also be able to attend live chats and debates with Marie and I. Plus, you'll be helping us to deliver more and better content. Now, on with the show. Welcome to the Data Science Ethics Podcast. This is Lexi, and today we're talking about proxy variables. Proxy variables are data points that are used in place of other information that is either impossible or impractical to measure. Let's take an example of colleges trying to predict academic success as part of the admissions process. They may have some hypotheses about the independent variables or factors that would indicate a higher chance of good performance. For instance, they might consider prior academic performance by looking at high school transcripts or GPAs. They might think about fit with the school. Maybe that would cause them to look at the extracurricular activities of the student and assess how many of those activities are available on their campus. They may want to ensure that the student has academic interests aligned with the curriculum. That could lead the admissions board to consider which major a student intends to pursue. More generally, though, they may want to measure the student's intelligence. However, the concept of intelligence is a very difficult one to quantify. It's impossible to truly measure intelligence directly. Instead, they might use standardized test scores as a proxy variable for intelligence. There are usually some drawbacks to using a proxy variable rather than being able to measure the variable of interest directly. In our example with standardized test scores, one drawback might be that some people have difficulties taking tests. Their true intelligence would not be adequately reflected in the proxy variable of test scores. Data scientists have to carefully consider whether the information gained by including the proxy variable is sufficient given the drawbacks, or if other information is necessary. In this case, data scientists might look to include an indicator of test anxiety or other factors that would influence test performance. There's another dark side to proxy variables, and that is confounding variables. Confounding variables are highly correlated to the variable being predicted, but correlation does not mean causation. Usually, both are outcomes from the same underlying cause or lurking variable. The example I always think of was one that my high school statistics teacher told us about. There was a study that came out showing a correlation between the number of televisions and the average life expectancy in nations around the world. Looking at just these two factors, it would seem like the more televisions a country had, the longer people lived. And while that was all true, it did not mean that bringing more televisions into the country would make people live longer. In this case, the number of televisions would be a confounding variable to life expectancy. The lurking variable, the root cause of both, is the wealth of the nations. Countries with more wealth tend to have better living conditions, sanitation, and access to medical care. They also tend to have the money for more televisions. That's not to say that there aren't good uses for proxy variables. Many fields use proxy variables to great effect. For instance, think about the measurement of health. Health is another difficult concept to pin down. There are so many aspects to it. Yet the healthcare field uses all sorts of proxy variables, like blood pressure, BMI, resting heart rate, and any number of lab tests. None of these is a direct measure of health. Instead, they are all proxy variables for aspects of it. In our next episode, we'll talk about a way that proxy variables are used in business every day to make decisions about the pricing of products and services. Thanks for joining us for this episode of the Data Science Ethics Podcast. See you next time. We hope you've enjoyed listening to this episode of the Data Science Ethics Podcast. If you have, please like and subscribe via your favorite podcast app. Join in the conversation at datascienceethics.com or on Facebook and Twitter at DS Ethics. Also, please consider supporting us. For just $5 per month, you can help us deliver more and better content. See you next time when we discuss model behavior. This podcast is copyright Alexis Kasson, all rights reserved. Music for this podcast is by DJ Shaw Money. Find him on SoundCloud or YouTube as DJ Shaw Money Beats.